Recurring document. So today we'll just do the interest posting. So before just doing the configuration for the interest posting, we'll just go through the PPT for the interest calculation. So what do you mean by the interest calculation? So here we have three types of interest calculation. First is the balance interest calculation, second is the item interest calculation, and third is the penalty interest calculation. So when we just is going to define the interest calculation in the system, so the system will just give you the ID for setting up this interest calculation in the system, and this ID would be S for the balance interest calculation, P is for the item interest calculation, and Z for the penalty interest calculation. So here it is saying that the balance interest the balance interest calculation we will have in the system, where what the system will do, so whatever the balance your GL will have, whether it is on the debit or credit side, so system will just calculate the interest, and if we just run a session, so the system will just find out all those GL where this interest is to be calculated and posted. So that particular thing will be done by the system, and the same thing will be done by the system under the item interest calculation. So what do you mean by item interest calculation? So here this interest is not calculated on the GL balance, but it is used for the vendor and customer account. So for example, whenever we just who would be your vendor, so from whom you would be purchase the goods or services, and the customer to whom we are just selling the goods or services. So whenever we just have a purchase invoice or have a sales invoice, so we just or the system create a line item. So it is saying that under the item interest calculation, this interest is calculated and posted on that particular line item. So for example, if we have customer and we are expected to get a payment from him on a particular date, but he has not paid the or he has not done the payment at that particular time or within that particular time frame, so after that, if the system, we can get the interest calculated for the delay payment, and we can just recover the interest from the customer for the delay payment. So primarily this item interest calculation, we do the calculation for the interest calculation for our customer for the late payment. So it can also be used for the vendor also. So under the item interest calculation, the interest is calculated on the line item we will have for our vendor and customer. Then the third, penalty interest calculation. So this interest is calculated on the penalty amount, and it can again be recovered from the customer, and it is calculated and or it is used predominantly by the financial institutions and the banks. So here we are first, since we are doing the GL accounting, so we'll just see how we can just configure, we can just set up this interest indicator for the balance interest calculation, and the interest is calculated for our GL balance. So for this, it is saying that let's suppose we will have a loan amount, and that loan amount is for the 100,000. Now let's suppose this loan we have taken on the 1st of January, and the monthly EMI we are just paying, it is 10,000. So So, if we just calculate the interest calculation in a normal way, so how it would be? So here it is saying that, for example, if I need to just calculate the interest calculation as on 31st December, so for 1 lakh for 1 month at the rate of 12%, the interest would be 12,000, but for 1 month it is 1,000, and for the remaining 90,000 for 11 months it would be 9,900. So accordingly, our interest calculation as on 31st December it would be 10,900. Now it is saying that the same calculation, how it would be, or the same interest calculation, how it would be calculated under the SAP method. So here it is saying that under the SAP method, the interest is calculated on the both side, whether we have the balance on the debit or credit side. So accordingly, we will just get the debit interest and credit interest. So for example, here we have 100,000, that is the loan we have taken for the 12 months. So interest would be for the 12 months it would be 12,000. So the 10,000 which we have on the other side, so we have on the debit side, so we have 10,000 for 11 months. The credit interest would be 1,100. So accordingly, it would be 10,900. So this is the again the calculation we will have under the interest under the SAP method. Now, how we can just set up in the system this configuration for the interest calculation, we will just see. So first, it is saying that what you need to do, you need to have a interest indicator. So what are the things we need to have? So first of all, we will just create the interest indicator. And it can be defined up to the two character, could be alphanumeric. So let it be AB. And for this AB interest indicator, we'll just set the frequency if we want to get the interest calculated, or for the monthly, we want to just get it calculated for monthly basis, or after every 2 month or 3 month, I want to get the interest calculated. So that frequency we can just set. Then in the system, we have been given the calendar. So how we want to get the interest calculated, according to which calendar? So these calendars are bank, Gregorian, Japanese, and French calendar. So what are these? So under this, we have different options. So how we want to just get that interest calculated, so that we can also see. Then after that, we have to provide the reference date of interest. Now, what do you mean by the reference date of interest? So this reference date of interest is your actual rate of interest. It is your actual rate of interest. Again, you have to give some ID for this reference date of interest. Let it be REFAB. And for this REFAB, what we will have, we will just give the rate. For example, we have the interest rate as 9.75 or 9.80 or 9.90. So for example, at any given point of time, you want to just get your interest rate change. So what we will do, so we'll have the we will just create the reference rate of interest. For example, earlier it was 9.75. Now I want to just create a new interest reference rate created. So for that, what we will do, we'll just create a ID for this 9.80, and we will just attach with the GL. So going forward, the interest will be calculated according to 9.80%. Then, so here we will also create the GL. So GL we will just create for the interest and for the loan, so that we can just get the interest and calculation of the interest and posting can be done. So this is what we are now going to have. So first of all, we'll just create the interest indicator. And for the creation of the interest indicator, we have step number one. It is saying that you can use path also, and you can also use a T code. So if we use a path, so just click on first, just log in. So it is saying that first go to the financial accounting, GL accounting, business transaction, bank account interest calculation. Then go to the global setting and define the interest calculation type. So we will follow the path. So just go to the financial accounting, GL accounting, then business transaction, then we have bank interest, bank account interest calculation, and here we will have the interest calculation global setting. So just click on this. So here it is saying that define the interest calculation type. So we have gone through the three types of interest calculation: balance, item, and penalty. So which type of interest calculation we want to have in the system. So just click on the new entry. So first of all, we need to just give the ID for the interest calculation. So that is called the interest indicator, and it can be given, the code can be given up to the two character, could be alphanumeric. So let it be ER, and this is in just a minute. So here we can just give the interest calculation in type as item, balance, and penalty. So since we want to have the interest calculation in the GL, so we'll just select the balance interest calculation, and the interest calculation type is S. Interest calculation type is S. P is for the balance, P is for the item interest calculation. So just click on save option. Click on save option. Then go to the next step. Step number two, prepare the account balance interest calculation. Prepare the account balance interest calculation. So if we just go to the system, so it is the next, this is the next option we have. So just go back. So here we have the prepare the account balance interest calculation. Click on this. Now just click on the new entry button. Now here it is saying that just give the reference of your interest indicator you have defined in the previous step. It is ER, and for this interest indicator, what is the frequency of the interest calculation? So just press F4 option if you want to get the interest calculated on the monthly or on the or every 2 month, 3 month, or 4 month. So let it be on the monthly basis, and for that we'll just set the frequency as 01. Then here we have been given the calculation calendar type. So there are four types of calendar we have. So you can just press F1 option to just see the detail for this calendar type BJFG. So it is bank calendar. Then we have Gregorian calendar, and we have after bank calendar we have French calendar, Gregorian calendar, and Japanese calendar. So how the calculation will be done? So here it is saying that if we just take the B calendar, that is the bank calendar, so the system will just consider, 360 days in a year and 30 days for a month. So which means that let's suppose in any month, let's suppose we have a March or a February month where we don't have the 30 days, so but the system will just do the calculation according to 30 days only. Then it is saying that as per French calendar, so your actual number of days will be taken as a basis for the calculation of interest, and 360 days will be taken as a basis for the calculation of year interest. So we can just consider the next one, that is the Gregorian calendar, where the actual number of days will be taken as a basis for the calculation of interest, and 365 days will be taken as a basis for the calculation of the interest. Now next we have Japanese calendar, where it is saying that your days will be calculated, actual days in a year will be calculated as 365 days, but system will just do the calculation for the monthly basis, or the month will be taken as 30 days. So the GE Gregorian calendar will just select for the balance interest calculation. So here we have G. So here you can just see again B bank calendar 30 days, 360 days, then Japanese calendar 30 days and 365 days in a year, then French calendar actual number of days, but the number of days we have in the year, these are 360, but in the case of Gregorian we have actual number of days and we have in a year we will have 365 days. So we will just take the G calendar, then just under the output control we can just select the balance plus interest, which means that system will just calculate the balance, system will just give us the balance amount for our loan, and plus interest will be calculated by the system. Click on save option, press enter button. Now the next thing, it is saying that you need to just define the reference rate of interest. So we have understood what is the purpose of the reference rate of interest. So this is the actual rate of interest. So the ID we have taken here, it is G1. So we can also take it as a REFER. So just go back and we can just close it. So just go to the next option, interest calculation. Under it we have the first option, define the reference rate of interest. Click on this. Now just click on the new entry button. Click on new entry button. So here it is saying that define the reference rate of interest ID. So we can just give it as a REFER, and we can just give the name as 9% reference rate of interest, 9% reference rate of interest. Then give the short name as 9% reference rate. Give the short name as 9% reference rate. So for example, if you want to go to, if you want to get the interest calculation done from 1st of January, so you can just give the effective date as 1st of January. If you want to get it calculated from this month, so the date could be from 1st of October 2016. Then in which currency you want to do the calculation, so let it be USD, and then click on save option. Click on save option. Then go to the next step. It is saying that you need to just define the terms also. Now what do you mean by the time dependent terms? So here we will just go through. So just go back, and the next option we have under the interest calculation, it is the define time dependent term. So just click on this, and here just click on the new entry. Now here it is saying that as we have just discussed in the theory, that in the balance interest calculation, system will just calculate the GL interest calculation, and this GL interest calculation will be done for your GL balance on the both side. The interest will be calculated whether we have the amount on the debit side or the credit side. So accordingly, system will just give you the debit interest and give the credit interest. So here we need to just, for the interest calculation we have to just provide the terms. So what are these terms, we'll just go through. So first of all, we have to provide the interest indicator, it is ER, then the currency is USD, and from which date you want to get the interest calculated, let it be from 1st of January, and we will just give the sequential number 01 for the debit side and 02 for the credit side, or we can also do other way around. So 01 we can give for the credit side and 02 for the debit side. So whatever the way you want to take it, so let it be 01. So here under the term you will find four types of term. You will find four types of term. So first we have the debit interest and credit interest. So if you want to do the balance interest calculation for the GL, so you need to take the two terms. One is the credit interest, balance interest, and second is the debit interest, balance interest. Now when we can just use this credit interest, area interest calculation and debit interest, area interest calculation. So this we can just do for the item interest calculation when we want to get the interest calculated for our customer for the delay payment. So in that case we can just get the we can just take these two terms, debit and credit terms. So since we are doing the balance interest calculation or the GL interest calculation, so we can just take these two terms. So first we'll just take the interest calculation, and that is the balance interest calculation. Then here you need to just attach your reference rate of interest also. What is the reference rate of interest? It is REFER. This is the ID we have taken. Now just click on the next entry. Click on the next entry because this is for the credit interest. Now we need to have the debit interest also. So we want the system to just calculate the amount on the debit side. So for that you need to just go to the next entry button and give the same option, give the same information. So let it be the interest indicator as ER, currency is USD, effective from 1st of January, and this time we will just select the sequence as 02. Again just select the term. Now this time again we will have it for the GL interest calculation, and the next term we will select, it is for the debit interest balance interest. Now again with this debit interest we will just calculate the reference rate of interest, and we will just attach the reference rate of interest ID. It is REFER, and then we will just save these two terms, press enter button, then go back. So what you will find, you will find that for your interest indicator we have the interest, we have the credit interest term and debit interest term, and we have also attached the reference rate of interest with these two terms. Now the next option we have, if you want to find out the detail, so just go to the detail option. Now it is saying that the next thing we will have, so we have been saying that the interest will be calculated and posted by a system, but for that we need to just get the GL also. So there are two GL we are going to create in the system. First would be your interest account only, since we are just taken a loan, and on that loan the interest is to be calculated. So this will be considered as a expense GL. So if we would have been where we would have given a loan to somebody, so that would be that in that case we would have created a income interest account. And accordingly, we would have created the term loan also. Now, in this case, we are assuming that we have taken a loan from the bank. So, accordingly, we'll just create a GL for the interest account and for the loan account. So, for the creation of these two accounts, we need to have the account number. So, how we can get the account number? So, for that, we can just go to the OBD4 so that we can just find the relevant account group. Under this, we can just create these two accounts. For that we can just go to the transaction code OBD4. So for the chart of account CAER, we can just find out the relevant account group. So for the interest, we have the account group interest only, and we can just find out the range. It is starting from 400 to 499. So between this range you can just pick any account number, and you can just create that account number for the interest account, and the same thing you can do for the loan account. So this loan account GL we can create under the account group secured loan, and under the secured loan account group we have been given the range as 100, 300 to 399. So between this range we can pick any account, and we can just create the term loan account. Now where we can just create these through GL, so for that we can just go to the transaction code FS00, press enter button. So here we can first create the account number as 400 400, and it is for your company ER11, and then click on new entry. sorry, it is ERIC, Ericsson, and then click on new entry. Now here we need to just give the account group as interest and the type, since it is considered as a expense account, we will just take the type as P&L, and it is the interest account, or you can just take it as a HSBC loan, or it can be loan interest GL. So it is the loan interest account. Now just go to the control data and select only balance in local currency. Then we can also display the line item for this GL. So for that we will just select the line item, and then we want to sort these line items according to which criteria. So let it be according to posting date. So for that we will just select the sort key as 001. Then go to the interest or bank interest tab, and then we can just select the field status group as G001, and then click on save option. Click on save option. Then the second GL we need to just create for the loan. So for that we can just create the account. We can just give the account number as 100 300 100 300, and then go to the type and description. So we can just go to the account group. So here we can just select the account group as secured loan, and for the secured loan we can just, since we have taken the loans, so this is our liability, so we can just give the type as balance sheet, and we can just give the name as HSBC loan account, bank loan account. So this is HSBC bank loan account GL. Now just go to the control data and again select the line item display, then select the only balance in local currency, and the sort key let it be 001. Now in the bank interest GL, what you need to do along with the field status group, this time you need to just give the interest indicator also. So here you can just see the interest calculation information in the company code. So since it is the loan account, in your loan account you are supposed to assign the interest indicator you have created. So here we have created the interest indicator as ER. So whatever the setting you have done under the ER, so that would be applicable to this GL, and accordingly the interest will be charged or interest will be calculated and posted in this GL. Now just click on save option. So what about the other field, like the key date of the last interest calculation and the date of the last interest earned? So that will be, these two fields will be updated by the system automatically, and we can, and these two fields will also let us know that for when did we last run this session, and up to which date we have get the interest calculated. So these are the two information which will be provided by the system after the interest calculation run. Now the next thing it is saying, that let's suppose we will also have a posting where will have the some balance in the loan account, and accordingly the interest will be calculated. But before that we have step number 7, where it is saying that we need to have the account assignment. So how the system will just come to know that this 400 400 is the interest GL, and this needs to be debited in case of any interest calculation on the debit side. So it is saying that for that we need to do the account assignment. So whatever the GL you have created, you need to just provide these two GL, so for the automatic posting. So for providing the account for the automatic posting, we call it as account assignment or assignment of account. So we can also go through the transaction code, it is OBV2. If we want to go through the path, so it is saying that you can just go to the prepare GL account interest calculation, and here we have, just go back, we can just use OBV2. So here it is saying that just go to the symbols, just click on the symbol. So here we have been given the symbol as 0001 0002, then 11 12 13 14, and so on so forth. So here it is saying that if, let's suppose we are assuming that the interest as a income we are just calculating, so in that case you can just take the symbol as 0001, where you are just getting the interest on the amount you have given to somebody. But here in this case, you have taken a loan from the bank and this is considered as expense. So in this case, we will just take the symbol as 0002 for the interest paid, and we will also find we have 1000 and 2000. So 2000 we will just take for that loan, for that GL amount on which the interest is to be calculated. So here, this is the two types of GL account given here. So first, 1000 crore for the GL account earned, which where you are just earning the interest and where you are paying the interest. So this is the relevant account symbol for us. So now you can just click on the account button. So here it is just asking for your chart of account. So our chart of account is CAER only. Just press enter button. So first we will just select the account symbol as 0002. And for the currency USD, so we have to give the GL on which the interest is will be on in which the interest will be posted by the system. So it is 400 400, and the second GL we have 2000 in account symbol will just have, and it is for just one. So it is for the currency USD. Just one. Okay, so here we will just give the GL account as 100 300. So this is the loan account. We have to just give the reference of our loan account, or the loan account number we have to provide here. Now just click on save option. So these are the two GL we have just given for the automatic posting. So whenever there would be any interest, so that will go to this GL, and the calculation for the interest calculation will be done from which GL. So this will be done on this GL only, 100 300, and then click on save option. Then it is saying that so for this we will have the accounting entry. So in this accounting entry we are assuming that we have received a loan from the bank, and for that we can just post a accounting entry, and it is F-02. Through the transaction code F-02 we can just enter an entry. So let's suppose we are assuming that we have taken a loan on 1st of January. So we'll just give the posting and document date as 1st of January 2016. And here if we have just taken a loan, so we have received the cash. So for the cash we have created a GL, it is 200 100. So this GL will just debit. So just press enter button, and amount is 100,000, let's suppose 1 lakh. And the business area is, it is, let's suppose, Ericsson. So the value date we'll just give it as 1st of January. So being cash from the term loan. Then the credit side, so our liability has increased. So here we'll just give the account number as 100 300, that is the loan account we have created. So that will be our loan account will be created with that, with this amount, with the same amount, 100,000. So here you can just put the asterisk sign also. Then the business area Ericsson, and again the value date is from 1st of January, from which the system needs to calculate the interest. Then the text could be plus, overview the entry, and then click on save option. Then it is saying that we need to just do one more entry, where we are just assuming that the next month we have just paid the installment of 10,000. So here we will have one more entry. It is on 1st of February 2016. 16 where we have just paid the installment. So if we have just paid the installment, so our loan account will be our loan account balance will be decreased. So earlier we have just credited it, now we'll just debit it. And how much amount? So that it be 10,000. Again the business area Rickson, and this the value date would be 1st February, being EMI paid. And here we will have the 50. So we have just credited our cash account, so cash balance has decreased. So just press enter button, amount is same, business area Rickson, and here we'll have the value date as from 1st of February. Text business area we can, or the text we can just give as plus. Now just over user entry and then click on save option. Now you can just find out the balance for your this GL. So to just check the balance for your GL, so we can use transaction code FS10N. So for our loan account we can just find out the balance, 100-300 is the GL. So here we can just see that we have just taken a loan of 1 lakh in the month of January, and in the February we have paid the interest. But here for this January month, if we need to just get the interest calculation, so for that we can just run a session. So like this GL, we have multiple GL where we have the amount on the debit or credit side. So if we need to just get the interest calculated, so we'll just use the interest run, and we can just execute it, and post that system will just calculate and post the interest. So for that interest calculation, we have step number 10 where we can just execute the interest run, and that can be done through the transaction code F.52. So here we'll use the transaction code F.52. Press enter button. Now here you can just give the range for your chart of account. So if you are using more than one chart of account, you can accordingly give the range. So in this case we are using only one chart of account. We can give the reference of CAER, then we are having the GL, only one GL we are having, it is 100-300. But if you are having multiple GL, so accordingly you can just give the range as from 100-300 to 399. So the system will just find out for how many GLs we have created, and where the interest needs to be calculated, and accordingly system will just fetch those accounts and calculate and post the interest. Then accordingly we have the company code. We can also give the range for the company code. So since we are just using the Ericsson, so we can just give the Ericsson. So in the most of the company we give the company code by digit, so accordingly we can just give the range for the company code. So for example, we are using the company code as 7700, and we have also the company code 7711-7772. So accordingly we can just give the range as 7799. Okay, so here we have just taken the alphanumeric, so, or we have just taken the alphabets, so let it be Ericsson. Now here we can just take the calculation period as from 1st January. So since we want to get it calculated for the January month, so we need to just give the range for this period. So starting from 1st of January till 31st of January, for which business area, so you can just give the range for the business area also. So let it be for Ericsson. Now just go down. So here you will find the under the output control, you can just select the checkbox additional balance line. So we want to have the additional balance line for the interest, and so along with the loan line item, so we want to have the interest line item. Then posting control. So under this posting control, so just select post settlement and update master. So why we have selected these two checkboxes? So here through this, the system will just calculate your interest, and system will update your master record as well. So if you remember, we have created a GL 100-300, and we have provided the interest indicator under the bank interest tab, where we have the two field, the key date up to which the interest was calculated, and second, the number of session we have run. So I selected this checkbox update master. So the system will update those two fields. But if we have not selected this checkbox, then in that case system will not update those two fields in the GL master record. Now here this is the session name which will be given by the system automatically. If it is not given, then we can just give the, we can pick it from the system also, like from the practice material. So it is RFGIS00. You can just copy paste. Then the business area, posting to the business area, it is Ericsson. So you can just give the, you can just give the reference of Ericsson. Now here you have to just give the posting date of this session and document date of this session. So let it be, so since we are just doing it for January, so you can just give the last date of the January as 31st. Then just execute this session. So this interest will not be calculated by the system directly. So first of all, it will just ask you to give the to just go through the calculation. So here there is a message which it is saying that in the OB83 we have missing something. So we'll just check what is that. OB83. Okay, actually we have just skipped this step. So where we need to just provide the interest rate, where we need to just provide the interest rate, and this is the step number 5. Actually we have just skipped the step number 5. After giving the term, we have directly created the GL. So we were also supposed to provide the interest value. So that interest value will give under the OB83. So here you can just go to, if we are just doing it through the path, so you can just go to the IMG and go to the financial accounting, GL accounting. Then here we have bank interest calculation. So the next option we have, so you can just see after the terms we have entered the interest value. So you can just click on this and give the interest value. Now just click on the new entry button. Click on the new entry button. So what's your reference date of interest? So our reference date of interest ID is REFER, and here when you want to get the interest calculated from 1st of January, what is the rate? The rate is 9%, and then click on save option. If you want to give the rate in decimal, so you can use the comma sign. After that you can just give the decimal figure. So accordingly system will just calculate the interest. Now it is 9% rate we have given. Now again we can just go to the F.52, we can just again run the session. So this time we'll just find out if the system will do the calculation. So again we can just give the range for our chart of accounts, CAER, then the GL range 300 100 300 to 100 399, then company code Ericsson, and we can just give the period ranges from 1st of January till 31st January, and business area Ericsson. Then go down, output control, select the additional balance line, and under posting control select post interest settlement and update master. Then session name we have, and business area, and document date of and posting date of the session, and then click on execute button. So as I just shared with you, before getting it posted in the system, So system will just let us know this is the interest amount. So if all the things are correct, so we can just go for the posting. So here the system is just giving us the information that this is the company code and interest indicator ER we have for in the currency USD. For the GL 100-300, the system could find only one GL where the interest can be calculated, and for which month? For the period range 1st to 31st January. And this is the interest loan GL, this is the GL description. Then this is the information for the for your interest indicator, it is 9%, and the interest amount is 764.38 credit interest, and this is for 31 days. So if all the things are correct, then we can just go to the menu, and in the session you have been given the option services. Under the services we can just select batch input, and then we can just click on the session. We can click on the session again if we have it. So here I can just give you. So first we can just go to the menu, then services, then batch input, and then click on session. So after that you will find this screen. So select this screen, in this screen you need to just select the session. So we have been given multiple session, but we can just give the, we can select the relevant session, it is RFGIS00, and then click on the process button, and then click on display. If any error would be, system will display you, then click on process. So here it is saying that in your GL you have set up a rule that without text system will not post any entry. So this is the GL entry system is going to post, but system is not able to fetch the text which you want to have for your interest document. So let it be, this is the interest, this is the text we are going to enter, it is the interest for the January month. Press enter button, then the same text we want to have for the second line item, press enter button. So the session will get closed, or it will get completed. Now just exit the session. And in the background, what you will find a counting entry has been done by the system, and the count number is the document number is 20. So this with under this 20, we can just find out our loan interest, that is the expense that has been debited, and our liability has been increased with the same amount. So if we just go through the GL, if this is the accounting which has been done by the system, if we just go through the GL. So what you will find for 100-300, so now for the January month system has also calculated the interest, it is 764, and the total amount we have for the January, it is 1,764. So the same thing we will be doing for subsequent month also. So this is the month and activity we will have. Now the balance we have, it is 90,764. One more thing, we can just go to the GL master record. And for 100-300, what you will find in the bank interest tab, you can just go to the bank interest tab. Here you can just see the dates. These are the two fields which have been updated by the system, where we can just see that the interest calculation we have done, or system is just showing you that this is the key date up to which the interest was calculated. It is 31st January 2016. When did we do this? So we have executed the last run on 18th of October 2016. So this is the information system will just provide you after the interest calculation posting. Okay. So this was the interest calculation posting. Now after that we will do the reversals. We have the individual mass reversals that we will do tomorrow. Now if any question you have, you can just let me know.
All right, Moses,
you have any questions?
No questions. Continue tomorrow.
Okay, Moses.
All right then.
Okay.